Currently, we're producing cobalt-60. Cobalt-60 is used to sterilize equipment. It's also used for cancer treatments. It's a really neat targeted therapy when it comes to cancer treatments. So we've been doing that for quite a few years now. But what we're realizing with isotopes is that there's more that we can be doing. Isotopes need some form of irradiation to go from the existing materials to the medical usable form of material, and Bruce Power can supply that irradiation through our nuclear reactors, which is really exciting. It's exciting to see different things that we can be doing with our technology that we have on site, and just opening that up to new opportunities to support not only the electricity world, but also the medical community. So the latest harvest has been really important when it comes to fighting COVID-19. It's been really important when it comes to being able to sterilize equipment that we honestly take for granted. When you think about getting a mask or you think about going in and getting anything in a hospital, you assume that they've done their due diligence in terms of ensuring that all of the pieces of equipment are completely free from any harmful stuff that can be on it. With the latest harvest, we were actually able to sterilize between 20 and 25 billion pieces of equipment. So whether that's gloves, whether that's COVID swabs to do tests, it's really just looking at those volumes that help us to keep everyone safe and to continue to fight COVID-19. In terms of the future of medical isotopes, there's so much potential out there. There are diagnostic tools that can be used from different medical isotopes. There's different therapies that can be used for treatment of different cancers, as well as different tumors within the body. Isotopes are a really neat technology when it comes to the medical community because they are targeted therapies. So we're able to actually find the cells that are sick and target those specific sick cells within the body. So whether that's through a diagnostic, whether that's through therapy, it's really just about evolving the medical community so that these therapies and these diagnostics are better, they are less invasive, they are less harmful for the patients going through the therapies, going through the treatments, and we're seeing some really positive results. So the future of isotopes is really just how do we continue to use them? And the flip side of that is also how do we continue to supply them? They do need some form of production mechanism. For us, it's providing that irradiation through our reactors. So Bruce Power is really lucky because we're currently going through a major component replacement program across our facility. And what that means is that our reactors are going to have an extensive life moving out into the mid-2060s. For a medical community standpoint, that means a long-term reliable supply of irradiation, which means a long-term reliable supply when it comes to isotopes. So when it comes to research and it comes to development and it comes to clinical trials, there is the runway of time to be able to produce these isotopes and to support the medical community, not only with what they're able to use for treatments and diagnostics today, but also in terms of research and developing what the next generation of these treatments need to look like. Bruce Power has looked at some really key partnerships in terms of continuing to look at what the medical community needs from a medical isotope perspective. We're currently working on an isotope production system to install additional capability within our facility. We've partnered with McMaster University, Isogen, and BWXT at exploring the potential for feasibility in terms of what those next medical isotopes look like. We've also been involved with the Nuclear Innovation Institute, looking at next generation nuclear, but also what that means for the medical community. So I think the future possibilities are potentially endless, but it's just depending on where we want to go with that and how we want to support that moving forward.